Blue Dragon Taekwondo is the area's leading martial arts facility. Learn self-defense, get in shape, and have fun in the process. Master Instructor Dave Colger and his crew welcome all new students of all skills and rank. Come learn from the best. Come learn how to defend yourself. Come and enjoy the excitement of martial arts from Blue Dragon Taekwondo. Now offering a birthday party special with a night of Taekwondo fun for you and up to 20 of your closest friends.
A lot has changed since 1966, but your local banking partner, First Federal Savings Bank, hasn't. We've evolved.
By combining today's technology with our timeless service to make banking more convenient and enjoyable, First Federal locally services every loan we do. We pay standard closing costs for first-time homebuyers, free pre-approvals, FHA and USDA loans are available as well. Apply today.
As I've said for 50 years, we don't want to be the biggest bank, just the best.
by sending me some cards or some homemade cookies or some Starbucks gift cards.
Okay, in case you're new and that didn't make any sense to you at all, Zebra Zone is actually the place where we come to learn new big idea values like honor and courage and respect. A big idea is something that grows inside you so it can change you and the world around you. Mrs. Smith, would you like to reveal our new big idea?
Do I look like I want to help?
Well, not really, but you usually do anyway.
I can't help, Mrs. Amy. I've been wrong.
But the big idea.
I haven't slept in 3 days.
Maybe you can take a nap after Zebra Zone.
No, I don't need you to ride in on your white horse and solve this problem for me. I have a solution.
I don't even know what the problem is.
It's my neighbor, Bart. He has 3 new sheepdogs.
Oh, I see. So they've been howling all night long and keeping you awake?
No, they're quiet.
But you aren't sleeping.
That's because they're staring at me.
How would you even know that? I mean, there's a fence between your yard and your neighbor's yard, not to mention the walls of your house.
I know they're staring because I stay up all night and I watch them.
That's just creepy.
See?
Weird. I mean, the dogs are just being dogs. Why don't you just ignore them and go back to sleep?
Because the fence is too pointy.
Stop that stare. Okay, let me see if I've got this straight. So you're staying up all night long, staring over your fence at your neighbor's dogs staring back at you.
Exactly. You see how he has done me wrong.
I think maybe it's time for a little intervention here.
Yes, thank you. Props, please. I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna get back at Bart.
Wait, your neighbor? He hasn't done anything wrong.
I have these sheep, and I'm gonna go tonight along our fence and jump things up and down, and so the sheepdogs will, sheepdogs will see the sheep, and you know what they're gonna do? They're gonna bark. All night long, and then they will keep Bart awake all night long.
First of all, your neighbor Bart has not wronged you in any way. And second of all, if you're keeping him awake all night long, you're also keeping yourself awake all night long.
I'm sure there's a workaround.
Tell you what, why don't you just go ahead and reveal this month's new big idea?
What's in it for me?
A workaround.
Fine.
Okay, boys and girls, start a drum roll on your legs for me. Now on the count of 3, say the big idea with me. Are you ready? 1, 2, stop staring, Mrs. Smith. 3. Forgiveness. Deciding that someone who has wronged you doesn't have to pay. Okay, now this time, just the people who think Mrs. Smith has a really creepy stare, say it with me. Forgiveness. Deciding that someone who has wronged you doesn't have to pay.
I see what you did there.
You're still staring.
You don't think I should make Bart pay.
Well, technically, he hasn't done anything wrong. But yeah, if you make him pay, you pay.
But what about these? I spent so much time working on them.
How about this? Tonight, while you're trying to go to sleep, you can count sheep.
Yes! Hey, any of you have trouble falling asleep?
No, just you.
everyone. We totally can't be late to see two directions.
Hi.
I can't believe this is Afghana's ticket.
It's me.
I wonder if the band's going to sing to me. That would be like totally embarrassing with all eyes on me, everyone watching. Okay, they can totally sing to me. After all, I'm so going to stand out in my one-of-a-kind outfit. Where is everyone? Soccer moms, but I got it all. What are you wearing?
This?
Yes, that. Well, I heard you talking about how much you were excited about your outfit, and I thought, I don't want all the kids to think I look like a buddy buddy, so. We can't go dress the same. People might think I'm copying you.
Well, I meant it as a compliment, Cammy.
I have to go change.
Well, wait, if we don't leave right now, we're not going to be sitting in the front row. We'll be like all the way out in Egypt.
Well, I don't know.
I'll wear my jacket. I'm just one person. No one will even know.
No!
Am I late?
If only.
You know, this whole costume thing may be very fashion forward, but it's really scratchy. And now these non-organic dyes, I'm pretty sure, are leaching into my bloodstream. And don't even talk about the shoes. I mean, really.
Well, then, why are you wearing it?
Well, as a birthday compliment to your fashion style. I mean, Mrs. F told me what you were wearing.
You have to go change right now.
But seriously, we don't look right this second.
I'm telling you. Here, can you just put this on?
Well, I'm no fashion maven, but not exactly like matchy, you know.
You didn't tell anyone else, did you, Mrs. F?
No. No one else that would matter.
You did it! Marshall!
Well, it wasn't easy, but to honor you on your birthday, I matched you.
You know what? No. I cannot do this. Not even for two directions. I can't be seen in public with any of you. You're all so lame. I don't know why I, like, hang out with any of you.
Is she upset?
I know, but I can't feel my toes.
Guys, we have to go find her.
Look, if we all split up, we can go three different directions. And then we won't be late for two directions.
Stop. I can only handle one direction at a time.
No, all they do is mock me. Isaac Misery calls me for fashion advice. But do my friends respect my talents? No, they just turn me into a three-directional laughingstock.
Cammy.
Cammy, we've been looking everywhere for you.
You can just keep looking in the other direction.
Come on, we can't leave without you.
Well, you should have thought of that before subjecting me to undying shame and humiliation.
And before subjecting my feet to these shoes. Look, Cammy, I'm sorry. I should have talked to you before I did the same outfit, and especially before talking to everyone else.
Yeah, but you didn't.
I'm sorry. Will you please forgive me?
Well, I have to think about it.
There's a van outside with all your friends, your cousin from up north, and like 99 other people.
Well...
And that lead singer from Two Directions will be there.
What? Scary Child is waiting for me?
Oh, he'll be there. On stage singing.
I said some not so nice things to you and Sam and Marshall.
Yeah, you did.
I was mad, but that doesn't make it okay. Can you forgive me too?
Of course. But if we don't leave now, we're not going to be sitting in Egypt. We'll be all the way in Timbuktu.
Okay.
Hey, wait. You forgot this. Okay, better grab one for Marshall too.
You sit there for now. Prepare, Leander Bane! I can share this awesome story of my friend Kip, whose cousin Brian has his friend named Elsa with his little sister named Gemma, or something like that. Anyways, Elsa and Gemma love the movies, and when they see the trailer for The Beauty and the Beast, they get excited. Just a little bit. In fact, they geek out.
There must be more than this provincial.
Anyways, Elsa promises Gemma to take her to the movie the second it comes out. But then the day they're supposed to go, Elsa's friends ask her to go with them instead. And Elsa says, I'll just take you next week. And Gemma's all, I'm never going to be happy ever again. And so Gemma decides she's got to get back at her sister for killing her movie hopes and dreams. My name is Gemma. Prepare to pay. So Gemma spends the whole afternoon coming up with awesome ideas to crush her sister. First, she decides her sister's sleeping arrangements need some upgrades. And then she contemplates putting a little surprise in her sister's lunch tomorrow. But then she decides the best thing is to take Elsa's favorite t-shirt and go all Edward Scissorhands on it. And then her mom walks in and says, what are you doing? And Gemma's like,
nothing.
And then her mom says, well, do you want to make chocolate chip cookies and watch your favorite movie ever, The Princess Bride? And Gemma growls, no! And then she gets it. Sure, what Elsa did was mean. But Gemma let that make her miserable for the whole day, which is even worse than not going to see the movie. And then she says, actually, yes. And they make chocolate chip cookies with Whoppers on it and Laffy Taffys, and then they just laugh the whole afternoon. And then Elsa comes home, and Gemma jumps up and says, my name is Gemma. Prepare to eat cookies. So kids, I hope this helps you remember, never, ever, never, ever, never, 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 never mix hot sauce with peanut butter. But also, to always choose forgiveness, deciding someone who's with you was not to pay. See you guys next time.
all the kids loved my grunge outfit. And, you know, I really actually started enjoying the concert once I was wearing these earplugs.
Scary Tiles looked right at me when he sang What Makes You Kind of Pretty. I'm so glad I didn't stay mad at my friends just to make them pay. And I'm glad they didn't stay mad at me either.
Two directions. Split in the woods. And I go the wrong direction.
Kimberly Fousey. you get your bird, you're so nice. Hey, Marco. Number four is Tyson Walkman. Number five, Sophie Wheeler. All right, number six, Audrey Whitman. Okay, our seventh is Braylon Jackson. Corbin Moultrie. Molly Moore, are you here, Molly? Thank you, Zebby. And our last student for this month is going to be Owen Lett. And he decided he wants to teach you guys how to cook. You're going to have a cooking lesson with Mr. Snyder. How does that sound? Does that sound good? Okay. He's actually a pretty good cook, so I think it'll be good. So next week, and I'll give you a certificate, next week you guys are going to come down and have a little mini cooking lesson with Mr. Snyder. Does that sound good? All right. Okay. Boys and girls, I have one other thing we need to do. So last month we talked a little bit about working towards a whole school reward, right? Because I said you guys have been doing so great. These are all of the star cards that have been turned in so far since we've started doing this last year in September. And we decided if this bucket can get full, then we're going to do a whole school dance party. What do you guys think?
I thought maybe this class would pull it out, but they just didn't quite get there.
In second place was Mrs. Malco's class with 307 box tops. But this month's winner of the movie and popcorn is Mrs. Bollinger's class with 301 box tops. Okay, are you guys ready for this? Next month, we're going to put March and April together. Winner of those 2 months, that classroom gets a pizza party.
Timbercrest Senior Living Community offers residents a culture of self-respect, dignity, and security in a serene atmosphere on 104 beautiful acres in North Manchester, Indiana. Timbercrest offers a comprehensive range of services and supportive care designed to meet your needs throughout the many stages of life. Come be a part of our community. Let us customize a living plan tailored to you. Online at timbercrest.org.